into your Tai Chi posture, you're going to be a monk. You're going to take off your robe. Live with me. You're going to drop the robe down. As a result, your shoulders are drooping. As a result, your knees are now relaxed. But more importantly, your hands, your fingers are to the side, not curled like I had it, but outreached fingers, but soft, so that your middle finger is along the seam of your pants. Your feet are together as like mine. Your butt is tucked under, causing you to then have relaxed knees. But more than that, something happens to the top of our chest. Our top of our body, the chest is sunken. When it is truly sunken and your shoulders are relaxed, you feel more weight on two feet. That feeling is called grounded. You are now grounded or rooted. Rooted as if you were a plant. The roots are now secure and stable. Beyond that, you have not just a cable that is drilled to the middle of your head, but that cable now turned into a silver thread that's so strong and yet beautiful that it's holding your head up to the heavens and skies, as well as going down through your body, passing through the chest, passing through your dantian, which is a couple inches below your navel. That is giving you the stability and the posture that is called the Tai Chi posture. So when we do golden cockerel, we know we're in our Tai Chi posture. Our chin is tucked downwards and not parallel to the ground. We're at 50-50. We slowly drain the weight off of our right foot. As it gets fuller in our left, our heel of our right comes up. Till it's on its toe, we slowly hold or counterbalance our left, bringing up our right for a golden cockerel. Coming down, hand comes down, fingers turn down from our counterbalance. Starts to cock up as we shift our weight, centering our hand, centering our foot that comes up. Golden cockerel stands on its left. Down. Shift your weight. Golden cockerel stands on its right. Power of concentration. Keeping your silver silk thread in line. Helping your dantian. Concentrating. Shifting your weight. Counterbalancing. One more set. Tucking your butt. Your final seconds of your golden cockerel. Same way. Right hand on the outside, shift your weight to the left. Up, in line, in, down. Left hand, left foot, up, in line, down. Shift your weight, up, out, in, everywhere, from your dantian, keeping your Tai Chi posture, down, one more set, up, out, in, down, shift your weight, ground your right foot, then out, in, down. That's what I want you to feel about, using the power of your back foot. No matter what that back foot is, left or right, it holds all that internal energy to then move and generate from the sides of your leg to your thighs and hips, to your chest, to your shoulders, and then upward. Okay? That principle holds for all movements that you do. even in plow hands, even in plow hands, rooted foot, shifting the energy to the other foot. Shifting that energy to the other foot. It can occur, it should occur. Now, we talk about feet a lot, let's talk about hands. So we know that we are always holding a Tai Chi ball that has air in it. We know that ball's grounded, so our fingers can never be on reach and softened, but it has to be curved. It has to take a certain form, it has to be a certain size. So can you do it with me? Doesn't matter if your right is on your bottom or left is on the bottom. But the bottom hand should be 2 inches below your navel, the other hand, the top hand, should be inches level. You're going to spin your ball. Spin your ball. Do it with me. Spin your ball. Making sure that you know that your bottom hand is in the center. Therefore, when you hold your ball, it should be in the center, not to the side of you. Okay? If it's on the side of you, you need to make sure that your dantian is addressed to that side. But right now, we're facing forward. Okay? Do it with us. Another way to describe it is that every time you rotate, you are not only spinning your ball, but you are using silk threads and pulling them and turning them. You are always connected, even if you're moving. You are always connected, even when you're moving. Alright? Now, when you advance and get out of a Tai Chi ball, you realize that the bottom hand advances. The bottom hand just doesn't advance this way. The energy comes from our internal force, okay? So it can never be very fast because that energy has to gravitate from the rooted feet or foot all the way up to our sides, to our shoulder, and then to our arms and our fingers. So can we try that? Okay. Put your feet together. Okay? So we're in our best posture because we learned something and we know that silk thread is working for us. Okay? Hold the ball, doesn't matter what hand on the bottom. Bottom hand advances as if it were serving a meal right in the center. Left hand, our other hand sits on the side, not this side, not this side, not this side, but down where we took off our robe is right towards the seam of our hands, right here, as if it were holding another ball, okay? Tai Chi ball, bottom hand advances, counterbalance to the side, serve the knee. Rotate, hold your ball, bottom hand advances, aware of your dantian and your center. Hold your ball. Bottom hand advances. Center, counterbalance, circling in. As you do this, make sure you can feel and see your silk thread holding you up, making sure that your chin is tucked down, your spirits and energy are uplifted, everything is very positive, very peaceful, very soft. One more time. If we were to stand here and do it for 15 minutes, I think you'd walk out of here and you'd feel very peaceful. So that's the feeling that you should get when you meditate the motion, which is Tai Chi. When we're early on in learning, we're busy acquiring form, steps, sequence. We sometimes do not get that relaxation, but over a period of time, that relaxation feeling kicks in. That's what we're striving for.